This is an overview of the cognitive radio OFDM example using the generic OFDM library in Agilent SystemVue. Orthogonal frequency division multiplexing, or OFDM, technologies are particularly well suited to cognitive radio applications because of the ease to which signals can be adapted to channel conditions and capacity requirements. This example shows a custom OFDM signal created and analyzed using the SystemVue generic OFDM library. Zooming into the schematic, we can see how the OFDM signal is constructed using the generic OFDM library. Payload data is being generated through a random bit source. The bits are then mapped into integers to generate a 16-QAM signal. Preamble data is being generated using a waveform source element, and then the payload and the preamble are being multiplexed together. A 512-point inverse FFT is then performed. A guard interval is inserted, and then the complex signal is modulated onto a carrier using an IQ modulator. The cognitive radio's environment signal is being generated using IQ data files, which are then effectively modulated onto a carrier using the CX to envelope element. A narrowband interferer is also introduced and summed into the signal, and then the narrowband interferer along with the cognitive radio environment signal are then summed in with the main OFDM waveform. On the receive side, the envelope signal is converted to a complex signal. This is equivalent to an ideal IQ demodulator. And then the guard interval is removed. 512-point FFT is then performed. And then channel estimation is performed to measure the received constellation. In addition, an EVM measurement is being performed using this EVM sync. So now let's go ahead and perform a simulation. Okay, let's go ahead and start the simulation. And here we can see our simulation results. The bottom graph shows the spectral results. The red trace is the cognitive radio's environment. The blue trace is the OFDM waveform. And the green trace is a narrowband interferer, which you can see is sitting in the middle of the OFDM spectrum. As a result, we can see that the received constellation is quite dispersed, resulting from the interference from the narrowband interferer. So now let's see how the generic OFDM library can be used to adjust the subcarrier allocation to skirt this interferer. So to do this, we'll move into the equation page of the schematic, and let's change the carrier per OFDM symbol from 200 to 160. So we'll go ahead and comment this out, changing the number of subcarriers to 160, and then we'll change the subcarrier allocation indices to reflect the 160 subcarriers that we'll now use. And resimulating. We now see the new simulation results. We can see that the new subcarrier allocation effectively skirts this narrowband interference, and as a result, the received constellation is much cleaner and the system performance is preserved. Thank you for your time today.